Welcome to Helping Hands, the program which takes a look at people and organizations that seek to help the less fortunate in society. Today, we take a closer look at the work that students of the Department of Communication Studies at Northern Caribbean University, NCU, are doing to help build their community. Come with us as we take the group dynamics and leadership journey right here on Helping Hands on Gospel Gems Radio. Giving back to society seems to be the main aim of the Group Dynamics and Leadership class from the Department of Communication Studies at NCU. Students of the class recently gave back to three institutions within the parish of Manchester. These institutions received much needed assistance through the students who did the various initiatives as part of their community service project, CSP. The institutions which benefited from the initiatives are the Hillside Early Childhood Institution, the Hillcrest Early Childhood and Preparatory School, and the Mandeville Regional Hospital. Helping Hands spoke with coordinator of the Group Dynamics and Leadership class, Noreen Daly, who highlighted that the CSP project is one which is done every semester and is worth 40% of the student's final grade. She further noted that the class is split into groups, after which locations are given to each group.
They are told that they must find out what the needs are and see how best they can fulfill that need. It is actually 40% of their grade, but most importantly, it is service learning, and yes, the focus is on how they work as a team to get the job done, but it's really about giving back.
The Hillside Early Childhood Institution, which is located approximately 5 minutes from NCU, got the assistance of two groups, namely Power Rangers and Exid. Team Power Rangers sought to uplift the dining area, which is currently being used as a classroom, while Team Exid gave the kitchen an uplift. Team Power Rangers consisted of group members Richard, Shanice, James, Abigail, and Moya.
Our CSP project was to paint the classroom, and we had a picture of before, and this is after. As you can see, we did some drawing. And we also painted Barney right here. Aww. Yes. And we did
Overall, it was a hectic job. We finished painting, as I stated before in class, but what we wanted to do was to make it more child-friendlier. So we came here every day so that the project could be completed.
Even though we wanted chairs and desks for the children, and we didn't get them, but we did what we could to make it more suitable and comfortable for the children.
Children, I hope that you love our gift to you. And in regards to the chairs and the desks, I hope that you enjoy all the things that we've given to you, and hopefully you can get your chairs and your desk.
Meanwhile, interim teacher for the class, who wants to remain nameless, says she is happy that her class was chosen.
You know, it's really glowing. It's very beautiful, and I think the children love the painting because, you know, all the children are Barney fans and all of that, so I think they are happy about it.
And what are your hopes for the future with CHIP as it regards the partnership with NCU and the Hillside Early Childhood Institution here?
Really, I hope we have a long relationship, and I am looking at the bathroom, and I think we do need to have even two more to accommodate the children, because as you see, their number is growing and they will need a little more space to do that. I am hoping to have a classroom of my own, because this is really the dining area, but for now it's good and I'm enjoying what I have.
And what are your hopes for the institution on a whole?
It's not really permanent yet, but I really would like it to grow. I really would like, you know, well, you're a partner with us, so the fencing will be up, and I really expect it to grow more, and we would be taking part in more activities that relate to our country.
Team Exid, who did their project in the kitchen area, also expressed joy at the work which was done. This team comprised of members Jody, Daniel, Lisa, Alathia, and Nicolay.
We are pleased to hand over to Ms. Watson, as well as the other teachers and as well as the children, the works that we've completed so far. We were tasked with the kitchen area, and we did some work. We did some plumbing. We did some works on the window. We gave it a mesh so that the flies wouldn't enter the kitchen. We also did two screen doors. And we are happy that we could have improved the environment for these kids. And while this group dynamics class didn't seek to evaluate how much we could do, it sought to evaluate how much we could manage our, how we could manage our time, our resources, and the setbacks we did have. So most of this was done through fundraisers. We sold cupcakes and donuts on campus, and also donations from family members. There was so much we wanted to do, as Jody will mention.
Okay, so we wanted to paint the kitchen. Unfortunately, the sponsorship didn't come through in time. However, we're still going to paint the kitchen. We did the plumbing and the screen doors also, so yeah.
And I think we had to be very creative, especially with the door mesh. We had the challenge of ensuring that the door mesh fit into the frame, and we had to, you know, do some work. Jody did most of the, you know, physical work. I tried and nearly hurt myself. And it was a very eye-opening experience, because it was a learning experience, especially for me, because I learned how to do some form of trade work-ish. But Jody is a very resourceful person. He did the plumbing, as you can see under here. You know, yes, professional work.
The nailing of the mesh.
And then also the hanging of the mesh outside.
Mm-hmm.
Also, we helped in the classroom era with the letters, putting up the signs for the teachers as well, and it was a great experience. And another thing, what we learned is to think on our feet, because there are so many challenges that we encountered, but what we did, we used the limited resources to make a tremendous impact.
So altogether, we are very pleased for the support we received from the teachers as well as Ms. Watson, and we are also pleased to hand over to her the works that we've completed so far.
Principal for the Hillside Early Childhood Institution, Lisa Watson, provided praises towards the students of the Group Dynamics and Leadership class of the Communication Studies Department at NCU. She recounted the experiences of working with both teams over the period of their community service project.
With Power Ranger, they were very much willing to do the task inside the kitchen and the dining area, in the sense that when they did just one artwork, I had introduced to them to do more artwork, especially in the dining area, and they were willing. They stayed on their job assiduously, so in order for it to be completed, for evaluation to be carried out for Exceed group now. When they came, I saw them one morning in Mandeville coming with the mesh, and I was so excited, in the sense that because the health inspector came and they said that we needed that. And when I spoke with them saying that we had given a timeline for the screen to put up, they dropped everything that they were doing in order to get the screen and for the door and the window completed for it to put up before the inspector came. And I was pleased that they made the effort to complete the task. With the door now, I was not pleased with the inches, but they tried their best to get the inches that I wanted. So they didn't frown or anything. They just went back to the hardware to get it changed. And I was moved because they were cooperative. For the overall, what would I say for the overall? No, I am extremely pleased. I am extremely pleased with their hard work and all that they did. Thank you.
What are your future plans for this institution?
The future plan is to make sure that the institution is up to date or up to par with the Early Childhood Commission speculation, and to ensure that it is child friendly and community wise will look upon this institution as one of the best.
That was principal of the Hillside Early Childhood Institution located in Mandeville, Manchester. We want to thank you so much for joining us today for part one of Helping Hands, the Group Dynamics and Leadership Journey, right here on Gospel Gems Radio. Join us next week when we will continue this journey as we look at the impact the students of the Department of Communication Studies at NCU is having on the town of Mandeville through their community service project. And if you know someone who is doing a charitable act for an individual, home, or community, contact us at ggemsradio@gmail.com or masters.oshane@gmail.com. I'm Karim Chang for Helping Hands. Keep it locked to Gospel Gems Radio.